When I was a kid, I actually got some of the meteorite sand from Canyon Diablo when I was out in Flagstaff. 37 miles outside of Flagstaff, Arizona, sits a reminder of the untold and nearly unpredictable forces at work above our heads. As you drive through the desert near and nearer to this landmark, the flat landscape begins to undulate. And as you reach the center of these ripples, you'll find a 560 feet deep hole in the planet that stretches 3,900 feet across. Known as the Canyon Diablo meteorite crater, its crater is one of the best preserved ones on the planet. Yet despite its impressive size and the fact that fragments of the meteorite can be found in the desert sand for miles and miles, it hit in the middle of nowhere and was, all things considered, relatively small. So what would happen if a meteorite was bigger and hit a populated center? Today we're going back 3,600 years to look at the real-life city hit by a meteorite. But before we get started, be sure to like and subscribe. Anyways, it was around 1650 BCE when the city of Tel al-Hammam began a new day in the Jordan Valley. The biggest city in the region, its streets bustled with merchants, politicians, working among the city's 50,000 strong population. The city was quite advanced for its time, mud brick buildings reached five stories into the sky, pottery was spun on wheels, grapes were cultivated, and bronze and silver were cast. Typical Middle Bronze Age society. But this city disappeared in just one day, literally wiped off the map. The site was eventually resettled a couple times throughout the ensuing millennia, but archaeologists have been baffled by the original city's fate for decades. Strange discoveries in the ancient rubble have been hard to explain. Many melted remains and layers of ash were found, suggesting a fire may have swept through and destroyed the city, but clay pots melted on the outside were smooth and untouched on the inside. Not the signs of a raging city fire. Scientists instead now think the city was the victim of a meteorite. But not like the one that struck Canyon Diablo. This meteorite exploded as it reached the atmosphere above the city and released a blast 1,000 times more powerful than the atomic bomb. According to Christopher R. Moore, a co-author of the study, the extraterrestrial rock exploded 2.5 miles above the city. The energy heated the air above 3,600 degrees Fahrenheit. All clothing and wood in the area instantly burst into flames, burning people alive and collapsing buildings. Swords, spears, potteries, and even the building's bricks began to melt. Then, a few seconds later, the shockwave hit. Winds exceeding any recorded tornado ripped through the city at 740 miles per hour, destroying anything that was left. No bodies, no bones of animals have ever been found at the site because they were all blasted into just tiny, small fragments that are irrecoverable. No one survived, and the blast actually reached enough towards the Dead Sea to disperse salt across the region, making it literally unfarmable for centuries. Many believe this city actually inspired the biblical story of Sodom being pelted with fire and brimstone in the book Genesis. However, experts say this event likely just inspired the biblical account and not is the city of Sodom itself. Either way, the question you're probably asking now is, could it happen again? Airbursts like the one that hit Tel al-Hammam aren't actually that rare in the modern century, though they are a relatively recently recognized phenomenon. The first verified observed airburst took place in 1908 and was the largest witnessed, at least so far. Known as the Tunguska event, this meteorite exploded over northern Russia, sending shockwaves as far as the United Kingdom. 80 million trees fell in an instant, windows broke 40 miles away, and a glow on the horizon was visible from the United States. A mysterious event at first, nations worried some sort of existential doom may be facing the planet. And in a way, they weren't wrong. But for decades, the event was simply unexplained. It took researchers recovering extraterrestrial samples from the blast site to really put the idea of air impact meteorites together. But as they did, they provided a solution to a whole host of archaeological mysteries that had been stumping scientists for decades. My favorite being an alien brooch worn by King Tutankhamun, who, when archaeologists discovered him, was wearing a glass scarab predating the pharaoh by 28 million years. The answer to this Egyptian mystery actually came from outer space. The scarab was molded from glass formed when a meteorite exploded over the Sahara, turning pieces of the desert into glass that can still be found to this day. In fact, we have a few pieces in the Ripley's collection. Now, before you go, let me know in the comments what you think of this out-of-this-world theory. Be sure to like this video if you liked it and get subscribed for more History Off the Record, and check out your nearest auditorium. You might see some space glass.